Hello friends, and welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this video, we will be solving activity selection problem. So the problem statement given to us is that there are n number of activities with some start and finish time. We have to do maximum number of activities without time conflict. That is, no two activities should clash, as there is only a single person who can do a single activity at a time. Let's clear the problem with the help of an example. Here we have three activities, A1, A2 and A3. A1 starts after 12 unit time and ends at 25. Similarly, A2 starts after 10 unit time and ends after 20. Now, there is a person who has to perform maximum number of activities out of these three. Let's see how many he can. If he start doing A2 after 10 unit time, he will end it by 20. Now there are two activities, A1 and A3 left. He can't do A1 since its start time has already passed. However, A3 start time is still achievable. So he will start doing A3, and when he ends, he would be able to make 2 out of 3 activities given. Now, how can we approach this problem? One of the solution is use of greedy method. We have three simple step algorithm that can help us decide how many activities can be done. The first step is to sort activities based on their finish time. The second step is to print the first activity. Next, for all remaining activities, we need to print them if their start time is greater than or equal to the finish time of previously selected activity. That's it. We have a solution after this. Let's quickly do this algorithm step by step. First step is to sort based on finish time. Let's take an example having 6 activities A1 to A6 and then sort it based on its finish time. Here we have the sorted table. Note how this finish time row is sorted. Once we have this, it's time for step 2. That is, print the first activity of our sorted table. Here we have A3 printed. Next, we will look all activities starting from A2 here. Since start time of A2 is after finish time of A3, we add it to our answer. Next, we have A1. Since start time of A1 is less than finish time of A2, we skip it. Next, we have A5. Since start time of A5 is 5, which is greater than previously done activity A2, we print this activity. Next, we have A6. Since start time of A6 is greater than finish time of A5, we print this. Next, we have A4. Start time of A4 is less than finish time of A6, so we skip it. Since there are no more activities left, our answer would be these 4 activities in order. Let's summarize these steps into a code. This code is taken from Geeks for Geeks. This function takes an array of structure. We begin by sorting our input. This sort is an STL sort. However, this activity compare is our own custom function, which compares two activities struct based on its finish time. We then perform our step 2 and print the first activity after sorting. Next, we iterate for remaining activities, and if the start time of this activity is greater than or equal to the previous selected activity, we print it. That's all we need to do to get our problem solved. Let's look at the time complexity of this algorithm. If the activities given to us are sorted, we can skip the step 1, and then our code complexity would be big O of n. However, for an unsorted input, the code will take big O of n log n time. Here n are the number of activities as input. With this, we come to an end of this tutorial. If you have any doubts or suggestion, please leave them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.